This is the latest from CBS 2 News.
Hello, I'm Amy Johnson. Here's what's happening. The father of a missing 5-year-old South Pasadena boy will stay in a jail in Las Vegas at least until tomorrow. His bail is set at $10 million. There's an extradition hearing set for Tuesday. The LA County Sheriff's Department will update the case at a news conference tomorrow morning. The new Arroyo Seco Music Festival wraps up today. The 2-day family-friendly event features 3 stages of music by rock, jazz, soul, and funk performers. Among them, Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, plus Mumford & Sons. Now, if all goes well, the festival will happen each year until at least 2026. And now, here's Craig Herrera with a look at weather.
Hey there, Amy. Hello, everyone. We've got some high pressure still with us. In fact, it's moved farther south, and that's going to warm us up as we go through Sunday and Monday. It'll start to cool off a little bit. It's the middle part of the week that you'll notice the big change. Meantime, a very weak offshore flow will keep plenty of sunshine going, clear conditions right along the coast, and temperatures right about average or above that. But you head inland, a whole lot warmer. In fact, afternoon highs for the coast into the mid-70s for a few days, low to mid-70s. And then the marine layer makes a good comeback late to Monday night into Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, Thursday morning. So we drop into the mid-60s for highs. Downtown LA, well above average, rather close to 90 degrees, 83 by Monday, 77 on Tuesday. The valleys go from the mid and upper 90s to about 84 on Tuesday and hover with those low to mid-80s as we round out the week, i.e. at about 100 degrees or so in the high deserts. We have excessive heat warnings in place through Sunday evening and temperatures about 105 to 110. Amy, the mountains will sit with mid-80s.
All right, thank you, Craig. A new update on the popular app Snapchat could put your kids in danger. It makes what you think is private public. CBS 2's Greg Mills shows us how Snap Map works and how you can protect yourself and your kids.
More than ever before, our privacy is a huge concern.
Somebody's watching you all the time, and it's a little scary.
And even scarier, private information about our kids made public.
I'm a pretty private person, so having anybody know where I am, where my kids are at, is a little disconcerting.
She has 2 daughters, Rebecca and Heidi. We showed them a post on the Murrieta Police Department Facebook page warning the newest update for the Snapchat app allows followers to see a Snapchat user's exact location.
It's a huge invasion of privacy.
Anybody can see where you're at.
Right.
Does that bother you? Creep you out?
Yeah. Nobody needs to know where I am all the time.
Another Snapchat user, Renee Wrighton, said she learns about apps when she downloads them, so there's no real surprises. She already knew her location is shared on Snapchat, and that really doesn't bother her.
I knew that it gives you a generalized location if you're in Pasadena or if you're in Beverly Hills.
What she didn't know was how exact that location is. Now, with parental permission, we asked a teenage Snapchat user to show us. Here it is. As you can see, it's pretty detailed. That Murrieta Police Department warning on Facebook got lots of comments from concerned parents like Vivian Lowe, who wrote, "My daughter showed me this. So detailed. Scared me. Going to ghost." Ghost means not allowing your location to be shown on Snapchat.
I will definitely disable that.
Heidi Bernstorff is going ghost and decided to disable her Snapchat locator while we were with her.
In the settings, Snapchat, location, never. Now they can't find me.
Going ghost took her all 5 seconds to do. Greg Mills, CBS 2 News.
And that's the latest from CBS 2 News. Remember, we're always on CBSLA.com, and be sure to watch us on CBS 2 News at 5, 6, and 11.